Welcome back, fellow bush babies, to another episode of Minecraft. And behind me, you can see what I've been doing off camera. We started this last episode, and I finally got it at least somewhat finished. We have a main road going in. It goes all the way up to our front door, all the way out to the clinic, and it gives us some building room on each side. And you can see there, there, and there, we have plots for flowers. And the big circle in the middle, that's going to end up being the fountain, but we're not going to be doing that today. Today we are getting started on the enchantment shop, because Frank has asked, Frank the farmer, for whatever reason, has decided he no longer wants to be a farmer. He wants to work in enchanting. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to build him a little shop. He's going to tend it for us. He's going to do whatever needs to be done. And of all the off-camera farming that I did, I managed to get all of the supplies that we need. And they're right over here in this chest. We have everything we need for the enchantment table. I did make the bookshelves and inadvertently ended up getting the trophy, so I'll put that up now. And all of these are the supplies that we're going to need for this. So we're going to take these, a few of these, and one of these. And we'll come back for the glass and the wool later, because I've got in my head exactly what this is going to look like, and I've got it kind of all planned out. We're going to start. We don't want it too close to here or the road, because with the road, we don't want the roof to kind of overlap the road. So we're going to start this about 4 out. This is going to be where it starts. This is going to go up like this. And we're going to make this kind of an oval shape. So it'll go up like this. We're going to do a 13 diameter circle in like this. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm specifically picking 13 because the enchantment table will fit right around in here. And then we do the same thing on this side. Out and down. And then we just bring it all the way down for a little bit. We don't want this to be massive, but we also don't want it to be too small. It's going to be a fairly small shop, but we want room to fit things like enchanted books and, you know, all of that cool stuff. So this goes in and then in like that. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then in, up, oops. A little over-eager there. A little too confident in my building skills. There we go. I think I've done this wrong, though. Haven't I? Oh, yeah, it looks like. Oops, oops, oops. Simple fix. Let's get some of this extra stuff out of the inventory. I don't need to pull up the map every time I make a mistake. And like that. There, that fixes that. Alright, and I didn't even make the same mistake on this side, it was just that side. Okay, so the door is going to be right here. And we're gonna have double doors. I like double doors. And then one of the things why we picked this is actually, let's be a little more economical about this. We don't need the planks. Since I've got the half slabs, it costs much less to make half slabs. Is what you put like 3 in and you get 6 back? That's a deal. Alright, there we go. And there's going to be a little bit of off-camera work on here because, of course, I have to deal with that stupid half-hour time limit. There's, of course, plans for the future. Like, if things go really well with the channel and all of that, then I would like to get better editing software than just Share Factory. Something like a better setup in general. But money is an issue, so that's just not going to happen right away. But we're going to make this speedier. I'm going to... I'll show you what I'll do on this one side. So, let's see. How do I... Okay. Here, here. Now, this is going to go on the other side as well. So feel free to, you know, pause, rewind, whatever you need. This goes all the way around. We'll just leave that alone. to here. Alright, like that. Then around on this side, all of this, all the way around, like this. So, I'm going to pause, I'm going to go ahead and just build all of this out, and I'll be back once that's done. And I'll fill in the floor too, by the way. Okay, so as you can see, we got that put in, and I'm leaving this part out just because we're going to do something different. Now, when I said that I wanted to do the multi-layered kind of going down in like I did over there with the house, well, we know for certain that we can do this here, so that's what I'm going to do. We want to make something a little more interesting than just one big flat surface. So, let's put down a block that's going to kind of... That will be our enchantment table. Then we'll have bookshelf... Oh, crap. Well, I got plenty of these things. I don't need to worry about it. We'll put down bookshelves there, here, and here. And see, this goes really well with the floor. So up here, you can't really see that they are bookshelves. Then here, and here. That should make 30, and if it doesn't, we'll just fix that later. So, then we're just going to dig all this out. Boop. And, oops. Well, I suppose you could just dig that out. It really wouldn't matter. But, just to save myself the slabs, since it's not going to be seen anyway, we're not going to do that. We're just going to shortcut it. We'll throw that down there. Just because I can't reach down under there. There we go. And then we're going to do the same thing all the way back to here, I suppose. Let's go back one more. Bop, bop, bop. Then, like this. Oops. Oopsie doodle. There we go. Then get a step down on each side. Alright, there we go. And this should be a fully functional enchantment table, you know, when it actually is an enchantment table. Let's start putting these down now. Actually, I put these back and I still needed them. And now we break this out. So, the idea here, and here, here, here and here. Here and here. Let's see. And right about now, we should probably get that glass. We'll put those there for now. So I don't think I actually need to put more bookshelves down. This and this, and right now we need this because the panes are not going to work in this situation. Three, one, two, we'll just go there. Then here, like this, and then like that. See? Just like this. Then we do just up, straight up here. We don't want the purple to become overbearing. That's why we're not going to be making, like, the whole thing out of purple. We kind of just want it to blend in, and I think it's a good color combination. Alright, there we go. Boop. And this side was different because this is going to be where the store clerk stands. But I think this should still be roughly the same. Yeah, like that. And we're gonna have this here, five, yeah. Instead of just being regularly framed, we go up like that, then bam. Think down by one. There. I thought I might have enough wool, but I might actually have to go and get more. That's surprising. I didn't think it would take this much. Use this just to get up. And put that here. And that there. And if we need more wool, I'm just going to go and get it from my wool collection inside. I'm not going to spend the time shearing more sheep. I can do that off camera. Boop, boop. And come and bring this across. Let's go across here. Three, three, three. Floofy. Floofy and floofy. And then that, that, and that. Alright. Now this side I don't think had a window at all in my original plans. Just because this is where the cashier is going to stand, or whatever you want to call him. No, no, no. Nope. Get out of here. There's also going to be a ladder on this side, because this side is where his room is going to be. And the ladder's going to go up into his little bedroom area. Oh, God, that ankle crunching sound. Oh, I'm officially out of... Now, this could change, of course. Like, in fact, I think... I kind of want to do this. That right? Put some floof in there. Yeah, that's better. What was that? Oh, okay. Give me that. I need that. Maybe this side too? Boop, boop, and boop. We'll leave it for now. It kind of makes me want to bring this window over by one. And get all of that back. Not sure why that keeps closing. Maybe I keep closing it. Yeah, that's better. That's a lot better. Alright, down there. Boop. Ah, cripes. Okay. Trying to figure out how many... Okay, three. Three, three. Three, and three. And then... floofy bits. Why? Then woody bits. Down here and get this. Alright, we got all of that set down. So, we got that taken care of. Now, I didn't do all that much off camera, nothing that you can't see. Added in the windows, added in everything. Ready to move on to the next floor. So, what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of pillar up with some dirt. Dirt, 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 dirt. Oh, before we do that, actually, there's one thing I need to do. Need this. Need these. Need these. I'm going to leave those because I don't know if I need those yet. And the ladders. Did I put the ladders in here? Oh, no, I still got the ladders on hand. Alright, there. put. He'll be right here and there. And then we don't need to pillar up with dirt at all. Use the slabs again. I don't think I brought enough, though. Did I? No, I didn't bring enough, but it'll be okay. And I'm gonna fill all of this in, and again, I will be right back once I'm done. But, you know, it's not that hard. You'll figure it out. It just avoid all of this and just fill in the floor. Okay. We're going to start working on the roof to know exactly how this gets placed. I forgot to bring the mer. I'm very scattered. I like to build, but then I get too excited and yeah, hyper and I like building. I love building. I like building big stuff, but even small stuff is a lot of fun every now and then, so. What we're gonna do here is the stair goes here, then crap. All right, fine. And then there. And then you're just gonna carry the whole thing all the way around. Basically just, you know, make it a roof. And if you don't know how to do the bends in it, you know, I'm going to show this at least once or twice. So just go around here, then here, then there. And then you pretty much just do that same thing. Aim for this bottom corner here, then you can just tack it on here. Then the bottom side here, here, and here. And for here, what you're going to do is pretty much that same thing, except inward, like that. All right. And then after that, this is actually going to have to be left alone because we're going to need to start the villager's room there. So we have to do something a little bit different for here. Actually, I think this has to go entirely. The villager's room needs to be here where it can be accessible to the ladder. So we've got a corner here where, let's see. Where his actual room is going to be, it's going to be like, oop, not like that. I think I can put these on the back stairs, right? No, I guess not. But I do think he can get back. We can get back up and down here anyway, so it doesn't much matter. As you can see, I'm sort of planning things out in my head as we go. We want it to kind of be circular-ish, so. Oops. Then, like, just through here, we're gonna build up the floor so that everything's not floating and weird. But, like that, and here, I think. Let's see how much space there was on that side. All right. Like that. And I know it looks weird, trust me, I know, but it will fill in, trust me, trust me, trust me. least I hope so. Don't worry, that won't be seen from the outside either. So we want this. Actually needs to go. See, like I said, guys, it's just kind of a trial and error thing. Need that there exactly. Right, that's a pretty decent sized room for my thing. That needed to go. It went over, I think. It seems like it leads off into this. And then this here. Yeah, that's right. Right, so 1, 2, 3. We'll build his house like 4 blocks tall. And we kind of want a little view for him, of course. So, oops. I need the wood. I need it. Don't take that the wrong way. That's dirty. Get your mind out of the gutter. Silly, silly bush babies. And we want them to be able to see out. Then here. We'll figure out windows afterward. It's not really a problem. We just need to get this built up enough that I can figure the roof out from there, because the roof is going to be a little bit tricky, and it's going to be one of those things that I'm hoping really, really hard that I can just, I don't have to cut things out, and I don't want to have to do a whole other episode. I don't want multiple episodes of this particular build. Oh, yes, those skills. Like that. All right. Perfect. Bit of a small living space for a villager, but it's a villager. They're used to small living spaces. They'll be perfectly fine with this. As it turns out, we don't need that. So, that means we can have that. Up here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and get all of this part built up. Once I'm done, it's just going to be this layer and the next layer up, so don't worry about missing anything. And once I'm done with that, I will be right back. Okay, so as you can see, we've kind of got this taken care of, figured out. I'm going to break this one right here. I think this was the one. It might not be, but if not, it's fine. We're going to go around over on this side and then place this here. Now, if this is uneven, it's actually okay. It kind of gives it a neat texture. What we're going to do is we're going to bring this up around again from here. Around on like the whole side. Then we're going to start going up by half slabs. So, like this. Then, you know, like that. Oh, crap. Then, like that. then that. So, again, I know I'm going to cut. I'm doing this a lot, but like I said, time constraints, placing blocks repeatedly. Trust me, you guys don't want to end up having to see that. I'm going to go ahead and just, you know, get all of this finished up, and I'll be back once the build is actually complete, because we're going to be doing the same thing on the top of that part anyway. So literally, you're just going to be watching me put down blocks that, you know, you're better off just being able to do it yourself. And again, you know, if you want a tutorial build, I will absolutely give you a tutorial build. So, you know, leave in the comments if you want a tutorial build on this place once it's done, once you see how it looks. If you want it for yourself, then just let me know and I will do a build on the whole thing. So I'll be right back once I'm done taking care of everything left in this build, aside from the decoration, of course. So, and here we have the finished product. Here is our little enchantment house. We'll go inside, check it out. Before we do, though, we are going to make the crowning achievement of our house, and that will be the enchantment table. Let's get this. Boop, boop, boop. And the book. Ah, come back, come back. There we go. Enchantment table and trophy. So, we're going to throw this down here. We're going to make sure that this max levels. Now, of course, we're not going to use it right now. It wouldn't be right to do that without the shopkeeper here. And up here, we have his little bedroom. We've got a little room for him to come up and sleep and, you know, maybe a little TV, a table, a bookshelf or two for him to read. But I think that about does it for this episode. I know that there's been a whole lot of cutting away and doing stuff off camera. And I also know that before anybody really wants to point it out, that things are a little bit asymmetrical up there. You can see it just from the side here. But I think it kind of gives it that quirky, oddity kind of thing. That I really, really like it. Oh, before we do go, or while I'm doing the outro, actually, I'll show you what those buttons are for. So, thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate it. Thank you for the comments, the thumbs up. If you like the episode, please be sure to leave those likes. You know, they really help me out. And if this is the first time that you've seen me, please subscribe if you enjoy my content and want to see more. I actually do need more buttons. But they're basically like, you know, big bolts or, you know, nails or something like that. So, thank you very much for joining me. By next episode, this will probably all be decorated up and the villager will be in here. But until then, I'll see you again next time. And remember, Bush Baby loves you.